a law for all time. So look how many years we've been breaking the spiritual law by not celebrating. God, I love you. But we've been breaking the law because we ain't celebrating Passover. He said, because you're not remembering that I brought you out. He said, so even right here, so this is a special festival to the Lord. See, this is a festival to the Lord, not to your pastor, not to the apostle, not to the prophet. He said, this is what you do to me. You remember that I brought you out of Egypt. He said, and not only am I bringing you out of Egypt, but whatever that you find yourself in life, guess what? If you remember the Passover, you're going to see I'm going to bring you out of that too. Just like how I brought them out in the natural, I mean, I'm going to bring you out in the spirit. So when you've been in situations for years and years and years, when you observe the Passover, God said, I'm going to bring you out of that too. So it don't make no difference how long you've been fighting this devil. He said, but when you celebrate me, I'm going to bring you out. Amen. Turn your Bibles to Deuteronomy 16 and 16. Because see, that's why you got to show. You got to show some people. Because they go, well, why are you always talking about giving? Because you got to understand that you never come to a king empty-handed. You never come here to him any kind of way. It said in Deuteronomy 16, he said, each year, every man in Israel must celebrate three festivals. See, there's three festivals the Lord said we must celebrate. The festival of unleavened bread, which is Passover. The festival of harvest and the festival of shelters. On each of these occasions, all men must appear before the Lord. You see it again. Lord capitalized. That means, in other words, Yahweh, because he's the one that's going to bring it to pass. So when you give an offering, God is the one that's going to bring it to pass because he see you celebrate his Passover. You see it? He said, on each of these occasions, all men must appear before the Lord your God at the place he chooses. But they must not appear before the Lord without a gift for him. Is that what your Bible says? It said, all must give as they are able, according to the blessings given to them by the who? Lord your God. See, we talk about Jesus, but we don't understand God saying, okay, well, where your gift at and where are you observing Passover? That's why during these three feasts, that's why these are times that we sow special offerings, because you saying, I'm expecting you to do this. Because God began to share with me that even when they celebrated Passover, because see, God was breaking the back of what was spoken over their lives for 400 years. Because you got to understand, the Bible says Pharaoh was a hard taskmaster. He was hard on them. He spoke accusations against them. And God said, people have spoken hard accusations against you. They have talked, they call you everything but a child of God. They don't ridicule you. They don't scandalize your name. They told you was no good. They told you was dumb. You was stupid. You would never have anything. And you got to understand the reason Passover comes. So God say that now I'm bringing it to your attention. Come on here. Now you have caught my attention by what people have did. I have heard your cry. I have heard your tears. He said, so now the assignment stops. Come on here. He said, because now where you felt like you was in poverty, where you felt like you were nobody, God said, I'm breaking the back of the enemy and I'm causing you to be who I call you to be. He said, no longer will you be in bondage based on the assignments of what man has spoken against you. No longer will you feel some kind of way because people told you you weren't good enough. He said, because I have called my blood to be upon you, and no longer will what they said about you, no longer what the doctor said you sick. He said, but I told you you are well. No longer what they say, I can't help you. But God said, I have told man to help you. He said, because when I see my blood, he said, I'm going to cause heaven and earth to move. He said, because your prayers and intercessions, they have reached heaven. He said, I'm going to make a way out of no way. And you say, how God going to do it? Because you got to understand, baby, that when Moses began to usher the children of Israel out, here, the children of Israel, Moses, you brought us here to die. See, that's why you got to listen to whoever God is leading you. Whoever that your leader is, you got to listen to the deliverer that God has placed in your life. Because see, that deliverer sees some things that you don't see. Because see, some of the people talk Moses. They start momming and complaining. You brought us out of here. You brought us out here for us to die. You lead us, because God told Moses a specific place to go. And he took them to the Red Sea. And they start momming and complaining. You brought us here to die. You brought us here to drown. You should have left us in Egypt. You should have left us being a slave. You should have left us being in bondage. And that's what we say. It was better in the world. In the world, I didn't have to go through this. In the world, people didn't act like this. In the world, people looked after you. In the world, people didn't talk about you. And God said, see that on lies. See, you believe in them lies of the enemy. And then Moses said, those who with me, you better let's go. And when God, when Moses began to go, see, I could just imagine in my spirit. He said, God, what are you doing? God said, just keep moving. He began to tell Moses. He said, go lift up your rod. Come on here. The Bible said that when Moses lifted up his rod, the Bible said the sea began to depart. I can imagine, because the Bible said, the Bible contemporary said it was nighttime. Oh my God. It's one thing when you can see in the daytime, but it's another thing, it's nighttime. I can't even see. I can't even swim. Oh my God. Can you imagine them big old whales, them big old animals in the sea, and they on the party, and he said, come on.